There we go. I believe in us.
Hopefully it's enough belief for the both of us.
Oh, right. We just activate this one here. What?
Sweet, sweet, sweet,
item?
Sweet.
What enemy is this? It's wisps. Why are these all malachite?
The
that's spooky.
What is the hell?
Well,
why can't I use my shifter?
Oh, bar? Right. That's one caveat to this area. Your character does not have the ability to use either of those here. So you're going to want to stack a couple other useful items.
Okay.
To heal you instead.
I literally just can't see anything when I'm outside of this circle, like with the meteors and everything.
Those meteors are a little bit more aggressive than I thought they were going to be.
Yeah, I mean, like, I'm going to die. Like, I know this as a fact.
Here, you just pick up as many items as you can. I'll hang out in the circle. So,
what's a healy item I should pick up?
So, Monster Tooth is good, and the meat, at least one of the meat is good. But Monster Tooth means all of those little health orbs are going to heal you. And we should be able to kill quite a lot of things. I mean, they're all over the place.
It's true. It's true.
So, it might even be worth getting multiple Monster Teeth.
Because,
look at your HP go back.
Yeah, that's nice. I like that. I like that. All right.
Also, if you want to not have the meteors, you can replace them. why don't you replace them with the missile launcher?
Oh my god.
Same effect, less problems.
Yeah, I think maybe one of us having it is good enough.
Well, I didn't pick it up. I have the
Oh, leash. You didn't pick it up. Oh, okay.
No,
this is just me.
Because I didn't want to doom us.
That's just me that's doing all of that.
Yeah.
Okay. That's just one...
Yeah, you're not even, like, fuel-celled to oblivion. All right. Might be worth getting a bunch of fuel cells at this point if you want to just be Missile Spam Man.
I would love to be Missile Spam Man. Them's the greens, right?
Yep. Let's see.
Is there like a cap that I probably should stop getting the necklaces? I think I got like three or four.
Three is probably good enough. I mean, really depends on at what point do you feel hale and hearty enough that you could do other things. What else is useful? I don't know. Do you have a teddy bear, by the way?
I have one.
Yeah, one is bare minimum. More of them increases your proc chance. Unfortunately, that's the only item that is not affected by the clover.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense. I mean, it's not an on-hit, I guess.
Tri-tips daggers do I have? Insufficient amounts.
Maybe.
Okay.
Alright, I'm feeling way less scared about literally every single thing after picking
up
a handful
more
items. Yeah. Just right away was spooky. I think it was probably, you know, the meteors.
You're not wrong.
Yeah, like everything is peachy keen now.
There's a decent amount of items here. So, I've never asked you this. I've asked, you know, like, about previous jobs. What did you have in mind for yourself if it wasn't for, like, YouTube taking off?
You know, it kind of, like, was in the process. Like, it was kind of the thing where I feel like I never actually decided because I was kind of, like, stubbornly in the back of my head, like... sure that it was gonna work out in some capacity to a stupid degree. So like it like I went, I like to school and took generals and general stuff like all over the place and just kept doing it and never was excited by anything. Like, I was kind of interested in I was in like a bunch of film classes. I was interested in that. I was interested in graphic design. I was interested in game design, but there was no good place to go nearby for that. Yeah. So I just never, it just wasn't an option there. I never got to the point where I really had to make a decision. Like, if I were to pick a very, very, like a very regular field, it would be psychology.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I mainly ask this, so I have like a massive amount of art footage that I haven't known what to do with for like a while. We did activate this. You just filched all the items.
Oh no! Wait, do I have more than you this time? I think I might.
I have no idea. Nope.
If
I think
you factor in green ones being better than I do.
Who cares? I am going to be virtually untouchable until the boss takes all of our stuff, at which point I'm going to be very touchable.
You said something about having a lot of art footage.
Oh, yeah. Well, I do a fair bit of artwork here and there, and it's like, I'm just sitting on all of this footage, and I don't know what to do with any of it.
Like time-lapse stuff?
Yeah, time-lapses, but nobody ever wants to watch just a time-lapse, so I decided I'd do like a Q&A series where it's just questions and art, and
yeah.
You know, I just wanted to see if that would work as a series, and so I've just been going through this like backlog of questions people ask me constantly. So instead of answering them every single time, I can be like, check this video, here's your answer.
Yeah, here's the big old section that just has all of the... Yeah. What does it take to become a YouTuber?
And so somebody was like, what would you have done? It's like, I have no idea, webcomic artists?
Yeah, no, that was definitely one of my options. Like, I always... Rhapsody and I joke. You can tell, like... how set I am, because
you should get sticky bombs. I forgot about that.
Ooh, should I stack them? I have one.
They don't stack that well, so just get one. One is
okay,
probably
fine. I got one. But like, I have a drawer full of, I am not exaggerating, 18 miniature notebooks that all have completely different categories for ventures that I would have taken. As far as just like this kind of online presence, it's all online presence stuff.
Yeah.
Like create, you know, like literally everything. I've wanted to do literally everything. I've made music. I have made a game, a mobile game I talked about before. Huh. Like I've done sketch comedy stuff. I've done literally like, I did an online comic. I have multiple different types of YouTube videos I've done. I've done like everything to varying degrees of not even close to success. But like jack of all trades, only patient enough for one.
Yeah,
basically.
I can see that.
Oh god, damage happened. Damage happened all of a sudden.
Oh wow, yeah.
What the heck? Where'd that come from? I actually had to look for a second.
I think you just got shot?
I think
so.
There
are certain enemies with, like, green icons that are extra spooky that start showing up after a certain point.
Yeah.
Okay. Man, I'm you from the last round. Your missiles are just killing everything before I get there.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't help that you have to actually be by them.
It's okay. Now I'm just running around with like 10 goat hooves, just going as fast as possible.
Ooh. Oh my god, I almost fell on that and stole it.
It's okay.
From the sky.
I mean, I'm just grabbing goat hooves and power gems. Let's see. Actually,
What's the power gem doing again?
Oh yeah, if you're close to it. A power gem is extra damage to anything within proximity of you. And so, not super useful for me. Or for you. Real useful for me. You want to actually pick up only green items, just get mad missile launchers?
Sure.
Because want to stack power gems until I am dangerous to be close to.
Yeah. Sure.
Ooh.
Do you know if the active item can proc on hit effects?
I have no idea. I know it can crit. It might be able to bleed.
It's hard to tell because everything's like...
Okay, you know, people are saying no.
It can't. Ah, the dreams didn't. I thought that it could. No more.
No fuels. And some.
Some? It can't proc the other missile, right? I can't have missiles beget missiles. That would be
the
dream.
I don't think so.
Yeah. Things are definitely, like, bleeding, but I think I'm bleeding.
I think it's most things just die before the bleed really sets in.
Yeah, I think it might proc bleed.
So
it might. I can't tell.
Let's see. Other red item that might actually be... You should probably go for the shield first, but other red item that might be worthwhile is Ceremonial Dagger for more just cascade damage / projectiles chasing things around and killing them.
That's the one where... That's with the purple daggers. What procs them? What makes them happen?
It's unkill. Just purple daggers fly out and stab another enemy.
That was on the voodoo run.
Yeah, that was on the voodoo run, but it would be pretty useful on yours where you just have a bunch of projectiles flying around chasing things.
Yeah. Very much just a... everything's gonna die somewhere. Some way. Yep. I'm sitting in the cell. And just... I'm seeing a lot of missiles go off, and it's nice.
Oh, wow. We're only still on our fourth cell. Whoops.
Going pretty slow. There's a... Oh, you got it.
There's just so many items to grab.
Yeah. Squeak, squeak. Squeak, squeak.
Speaking of, I guess, YouTube success, do you got a plan for your play button?
No. Put it on my wall, I guess.
I would not actually recommend that. Check the build quality first. The back falls off.
Oh, really?
Yep.
I have... On my wall, I have a watercolor painting Grace made for when I got 1,000 subscribers.
Aww.
And that is my cherished plaque of that kind. It's a watercolor painting of my old YouTube avatar that used a custom character I made in Scribble Knots.
You know what? I've heard worse. Let's see. This is gonna throw some shade your way, I guess, but I was looking at the wholesome verse and how all of us are just white dudes with brown hair. I've mentioned this before. But I've been approached by some other people to like potentially do collaborations with me, and I look at all of their icons and it's always white dude brown hair. And
yeah.
So I was thinking about it as like Scribble Knots thing might have stood out more. I don't know.
Oh, I mean, it was a Scribble Knots thing of a white dude with brown hair. So.
Fair enough. All right, never mind.
It's the thing where it's like, at this point, I feel like I can't change it so much.
Yeah, it's impossible. You are locked in.
Yeah, I kind of locked in.
You change your glasses color and somebody would notice.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I kind of locked in when I made the Scribble Knots character. Ever since then, it's been different variations of that. If I change it too much... People get confused about very simple things, I've noticed, so that seems like one that would do it too. Like, I don't know who I'm subscribed to anymore.
I definitely did have that problem. There was a YouTuber a while ago, 100,000 subscribers, completely rebranded one day without mentioning it, and so suddenly he went from, like, Ace Gaming to, like, gosh, I don't even remember, it was, like, Ventura something. And I looked at my sub list and I'm like, who is this person? And
yeah.
I went and looked at it and it's like, oh yeah, it's this guy. Oh, he's like throwing everything out the window. Now he's a Minecraft YouTuber.
Oh.
Bye.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to be a Minecraft YouTuber too, by the way. My first solo series was a Minecraft series. It's true. Huh.
So but. You actually started a duo with Grace or something then?
No, I didn't do anything with Grace until like 2017.
Okay.
2011 is when it started. It was a long, long time. Couch Couple was the first thing Grace and I really did.
Okay.
And it didn't last very long. Now yeah. We just do the streams, which honestly is more content than like a daily 12-minute video anyways. Like, because that was back in the time where daily 12-ish minutes, like, that's all
that was the standard.
Yeah, it was the standard, and it's all I could really like convince to do. Like I was at that point, I was doing like at least 30-minute videos. You know, when you start doing roguelikes, you kind of
you can't just do 15-minute videos.
You can't do 15 minutes. 15 doesn't work for that.
Yep.
Like you can split it like you're doing into, you know, 30 something. But you split it down to 12, people are like, I'm not going to care about this run by the third episode, fourth episode. I will not care about the run anymore.
I only do that for a very small subset.
Yeah. I mean, you're probably doing it for these, right? Since they're so long?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. These are so long.
They're just ridiculous. Yeah,
and I do that with Undermine and a couple other ones. It's just, Undermine's, I don't know. For the sake of my sanity and schedule, so I don't have to, like, record constantly to keep up with like hour-long episodes, I'm just like, yeah, I'm just gonna half an hour, 45 minutes, maybe 50 if it's something I'm really into or if I have stupid amounts of footage of. So like I have a Resident Evil 2 series that has never hit YouTube that I just edited yesterday. Finally, it's like, yeah, almost all of these episodes are an hour long because whatever.
Yeah, at that point you might as well
If it's something like Rogue Legacy, yeah, I'll cut it down to half an hour just so I don't have to record Rogue Legacy every day to keep up.
Yeah. Rogue Legacy's like, it's a dream to have a game where losing is expected and each
yes.
run is about 12 minutes and you can do multiple runs in an episode.
Yep.
Oh my god, it's such a dream because, you know, like the one huge downside I have with not cutting things like Neon Abyss or something is you see the run, if it's under an hour, that boy lost.
Yep.
Guess I won't watch because that's
I ran into that with quite a number of Slay the Spire videos where some of them would be like 24 minutes long because, you know, it'd be a great run, but I just get utterly wrecked by, I don't know, two gremlin knobs at once or something, you know, just out of my control. And it was just like a 50% loss in videos, and I'm like, or 50% loss in views, and I'm like, oh, this sucks.
Yeah, I'm kind of like, I wish that there was like some kind of tag I could put on the title that I'm like, yes, I know, we both know it's a loss, but please, this one is really like, this is a much cooler run. I lost because I tried something cool and it didn't work. Please click this one.
Yeah.
But like, yeah, it's very much just, it's crazy how much it impacts the views if it's clear it's not a win. And that's what puts so much pressure on me all the dang time.
Yep.
I'm like, I need to win, otherwise people like,
well, you raised the expectation. You were the Gungeon guy, which is like, that's a hard game. You know, maybe Sleep Cycles was as good as you. Maybe he still is, but
like at a certain point for Gungeon we were talking, like, I could streak Gungeon in my sleep at this point because once you kind of crack the code,
Yeah.
That's kind of like the downside of it being more on the player skill than Binding of Isaac is like you kind of have that on the edge of your seat feeling where you're like, oh man, I got a pretty bad run. Can I bring it back? In Gungeon, if you have a bad run, it's just because you have a boring run.
Yep.
Which is not a fun. It's not a fun bad. Like this is one of the runs where I got nothing interesting for the thumbnail. So I'm going to call it a run of Enter the Gungeon, not clickbait, which is a real thing I did.
If it works.
It said a run of, it was literally that because I would always feature the item in the thumbnail and then, you know, build the title around it. I literally put nothing in the thumbnail where the items usually go. And I said a run of Enter the Gungeon, in parentheses, not clickbait. And it got a lot of views compared to the normal episodes in the series. people are wild.
That little amount of sardonic commentary is all it takes.
Yeah, some of the weirdly highest views are like the ones where I'm like, I cannot think of anything that is relevant about this run to put in it. And like, I had one that I literally called, it was called the song My Console from hit band Eiffel 65's album Europop. And it had a picture of the album Europop by Eiffel 65 in the thumbnail. And that was one of the most viewed videos in the series at the time.
For any specific reason or just because you felt like
I felt like naming it that because I was like on a, I just remembered listening to that song as a kid a lot.
Yeah.
And how at the time I thought, I was like, wow, I feel seen. I don't know. Have you the song?
Yeah. So Eiffel 65 was the, Eiffel 65, admittedly, I'm super terrible. So all I really know is just the Eiffel 65 sound. Because I can't hear lyrics. It's just all mosh for me.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the lyrics to My Console are a very great treat that you must read. You don't have to listen to the song. Just read the lyrics because it's literally just PlayStation game titles and that's it.
Really? Love that. Yeah.
Metal Gear Solid. Yeah. We're going to play the PlayStation all day from Metal Gear Solid to Tekken 3 is literally the starting lyrics.
Whoops. Do not shift tab. Well, the merch gets aggressive. Yeah, Eiffel 65 was the band that got me through homesickness when I was a freshman in college because I, you know... It wasn't fun being super far away from my family with a bunch of other random people and a workload that made, like, my classmates cry.
Yeah.
Probably would have made me cry, too, but I just didn't have time.
Yeah, those cats, I definitely resonate with that.
Wow.
I'd cry if I had time.
I just looked at the lyrics.
Yeah. Just
the chorus is...
PlayStation.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I must have heard that song 1,000 times, and I don't think I've ever, like, acknowledged its existence.
Yeah. If you go to the comment section of one of the lyric videos on YouTube, my subscribers are all up in there. It is, it's a treat. I can't get the starting thing out of my head. Just how they rhyme Tekken 3. Not Tekken 3, Tekken 3.
Yeah.
Gotta make it rhyme. It's so good.
I mean, maybe that's just Eiffel 65's, like, way of saying 3.
I guess so.
It's like my dad and Labyrinth and me and Debris.
Labyrinth.
Yeah.
My mom and Artesian.
You know, I actually thought it was Artesian for a while.
I mean, me too. My mom told me it was.
I wonder if it's a Minnesota thing, actually.
It genuinely might be.
Because I had somebody actually correcting us on a number of, like, dialect things. And I looked it up and said, oh yeah, these are localized to Minnesotans.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's interesting. I'm in a scenario because, yeah, like... If I have a dialect thing, it might be totally normal to you. And if I have a dialect thing with Rhapsody, he's like, that's an American thing, you know? Yep. So it's like, I never get called on anything because of it. I did specifically change the way I pronounce roof, though.
Because you used to do roof?
It. I used to do roof, yeah.
Yeah.
Roof and rum.
I still do roof, milk, pop instead of soda.
Yeah. I don't know if I can't. That's the one where I hear that all the time, and I don't know what I naturally would have done because I feel like I go all over the place because that's a thing that I heard early that it's weird. So I think I like tried to change it about myself for some reason. You hear that, and I don't know what it is that makes you like sometimes, or at least makes me want to change it, like as if it matters. Like I got to be right about. Roof. As if it matters.
Yeah, as if it matters. No, I just own dialect stuff and then come up with whatever garbage I can because it annoys people.
Yeah, I do a lot of things where I like just will totally wildly get off base on purpose, and I get called on that a lot, which is funny. Like I think some people in the Wholesomeverse think I don't know how to pronounce a couple things that are very normal, but it's very much a I'm trying to make the word sound funny situation.
Yeah.
Like it's fun.
That's the easiest one we can go with.
That's
infected my brain.
Yeah, like I can't not say Beeg instead now. It's just, well, at least especially when it's related to video games. Ooh, the red items are here. It's been so long since I've been told what the good item would be. The shield?
Yeah. The shield is real good for you.
All right.
I have to decide if I even want any of these.
If you don't, I'll take something.
I'm trying to decide if there's anything that's actually amazing on me.
Oh no. Oh no, Wander. I just learned.
Yeah?
I just learned you can charge the left click. I'm gonna be commented on!
I told you about it.
I was busy learning the other 2,000 things. I'm gonna be commented on.
Yeah, here, why don't you come take the get the dagger, maybe?
The dagger. Okay.
Yeah, the dagger or the hook are probably gonna be more useful on you than me.
Yeah. Comment section. I promise I know it in the history of how time works. I know it before you. Please. Please, I know it already.
I have actually taken to for certain games where like I don't find a thing immediately or I don't learn a mechanic. In the first episode I'll like do an artificial outro after the fact and be like, yeah. I find it in episode 3. Don't bug me about it.
Yeah. I've been having fun just tap shooting.
Yeah, I mean, it works great for you. I'm surprised you didn't put two and two together, seeing as you can't just hold down to shoot.
I mean, it's a shotgun.
True.
So shotguns, you'd normally have to tap shoot. So that's why in my head I was like, it's a tap shoot. You don't charge most shotguns. Also, robots aren't real in this capacity. Oh boy. Oh yeah. We have to figure... I have to refigure out how difficult everything is. Seems like it's not that bad.
Nope.
What white items do you think are a good idea right now?
Let's see. For you? Like, maybe
is there any
crowbar?
More on-hits I'm missing?
White items.
The stun grenade? Should I get the stun grenade?
Yeah, the stun grenade is a chance.
Okay.
It's a 5% chance. You think? And you can... Oh, apparently if you max that out... it's an emergency drone. If you max that out, it's just 100% chance to stun enemies for 2 seconds. That's actually really good. You just have to stack 20 of them.
Alright. I'm on the case. That's a way to get survivability.
Yeah. I wonder.
That's a fun hit.
That can't work against the boss, can it?
I don't know. There were some weird things that were able to work against the boss.
Yeah.
Do I still need 20 if I have 2 clovers?
No, you probably only need like 8 to get effectively there.
Oh, okay.
Bosses are immune to stun.
Okay, maybe I don't care enough then. Probably not enough to use 8 item slots on it then.
Yep. Woo.
Do they hit big?
They hit big.
They hit big? Oh no.
I was just standing still for a bit and it went bad.
What are you looking for especially? What tier of they hit big. What tier of item are you exceptionally looking for?
I've been mostly going for white items because I can stack
that's super far away.
Let's see. I can stack the power bobble, which makes it so I heal. Or not heal, I do just tons of damage on anything in proximity.
Yeah. which is all because melee.
Yeah. Because I do not have a single ranged attack, and that's why I didn't want to go for the dagger, because it's like, I bet that's actually just more useful on you. Okay, I'm going to go hit the portal.
Okay. I'm going to get over there, put down my moves that I didn't have for the past 15 minutes.
Yeah, you got to re-remember those. Hopefully they add it back in so you get to use it. Oh boy. So I'm used to a much a much larger arena here. So I've been investing really hard in movement speed so that I can turbo dash like across the map. It is too much dash, and it's actually very difficult for me to come back. we're pretty safe.
Yeah, you're fine.
Oh, huh. It won't let me go over there. I feel cheated.
That's not fair.
I was gonna, fly over to one of those weird islands. I can get up here. Is there anything interesting? What the? No! Why would they do that? Oh.
They just put the island there and you can't make it there?
No, you make it halfway and it teleports you backwards 30 feet. And it's like, oh, don't.
Even worse. That's so much worse. That's so much worse than just not being able to do it.
Oh, activating, might be worth getting one Warhorn.
One Warhorn? What color is that?
It's a green item.
Okay.
Activating your equipment gives you a burst of attack speed, which, should be just kind of perpetual. There we go.
Can't believe that this is monsoon.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah. This takes a bit to get there.
The difficulty system is weird. God, it's so weird. I don't know how I feel about it yet.
Yeah, it kind of caps out, sort of. The real trick is just we spend a lot of time on
the
portals.
The freebies. Yeah.
Yeah. Where nobody can touch us. Let's see. Did we forget the backpack? Or did you get the backpack from the guy?
I did not get any backpack.
Oh.
Yet. Wait, here's a backpack. Wait, is this the backpack man?
Yeah, because there's a couple of backpack men just all over the place.
Oh, there's still... Oh, yeah, there's still...
No, no.
That's because it's our enemy?
No, these aren't the backpack men. They just look like the backpack man.
Here's a white item.
Okay.
Did you find the escape?
Yep.
Just want to go there and put down. Oh, there it is. This is it, right? Teleported question mark.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Oh, hi, boys. Defeat an elite boss on monsoon difficulty.
Yeah.
This game is very easy, and I'm very, very good at it. Just ignore the part where I tap shoot my gun the whole time. Should I get the blood thing now? Or is one of these a non-hit?
Let's see. Yeah, the claw. Is a chance on hit to fire a fireball. I just picked that one up.
Okay. The claw.
I'm not actually sure which one is better, but...
Eh.
Oh, well.
Between the blood and the claw?
Yeah. I mean, we are busted strong anyway. So, I guess unrelated thing that I guess is kind of relevant, seeing as I'm going to be... I have to think about it before tomorrow. Do you, in your head, have a definition of what is a roguelike versus a roguelite?
Oh, boy. I feel like it's been watered down, and my current thought in 2020 is only just roguelite has meta progression between the runs. That's what it's boiled down to in 2020.
Yeah.
I used to be a lot more specific about it. but now I'm just like, if you can make your character stronger between runs, it's a roguelike.
That's the light. Yep.
Yeah.
That's
where I've landed now, because anything else is just 4 years of it has been exhausting. And people have kind of like, you know,
grounded into the dust. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's just like, I've stopped getting comments that are like, actually, it's a roguelike.
I've noticed that I think a lot of people have like just peaced out on even defending it anymore. Like, apart from if you go to the roguelike Reddit,
yes,
where I think people are very aggressive about it.
Yes. Yes. 100%. Yes. There's two white items over here.
All right.
Portal.
I've hit the portal.
Okay.
Oh my god. I just seeing numbers tick down.
Yeah, I don't know where the boss is, but I think it's gone. I put down the healing aura.
Apparently, because we have the thing where only one enemy can spawn in, there are no boss monsters. There's just enemies that act as bosses.
Enemy waves,
They just give us like a giant horde of them, which
I kind of like it.
Yeah, I kind of like it. Especially with your kind of setup that's just like, hey, how do you feel about more missiles?
Yeah. My setup is little enemies. Oh, well, they're gone. Boss? Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Good thing there are none. Good thing there's none of those.
I'm really hoping we get to the final level and it's just like that entire mess with the last boss is just, just like 5,000 enemies stacked in that small area.
I would love that. It's just the standard lizard enemy.
But there, it's just like a sea of them. It turns into Creeper World for a bit.
Oh, boy.
It's kind of pathetic. I've gotten to the point where I'm not really attacking again.
Yeah. Like I say, it's always Cookie Clicker. It always gets down to, and it's even less than Cookie Clicker. Always gets down to, how do I click the least? The run.
We're gonna just start getting backup magazines and Hapu feathers so I can just fly. Do you actually have anything you're working towards, or it's just like, meh?
I was trying to get another jump. I kind of don't know. I feel like I'm so strong that I don't know what I'm going to need until we get to the boss, and then I just die.
I'm just picking up items that I figure are going to make him vaguely useless. Like,
I feel like
what's he
going
to do with
good.
The billion Hapu feathers?
Yeah. He don't use them. He don't know how to jump.
I don't even know. Well, he does have, like, one jump, but...
He has that one jump, but I don't think this is going to make him... Do it 10
How great
times.
Would that be if it made him go, fire himself into space?
I would love that. You kill him because you give him too many Hapu feathers that he jumps into the sun.
That would be the best Easter egg. It's just a bonus cutscene. And then with the 50 Hapu feathers he stole, he fired himself into the sun. Everybody else went home happy.
It's like distracting Ganondorf with the fishing rod in Wind Waker.
Oh, I've never done that. I actually have never played Wind Waker.
It's very good. I haven't played it through all the way, but I have watched through it all the way a couple times.
Wind Waker is weird for me because it's the first game I ever bought as kind of like a working adult. I went out and bought the special edition Wii U, and it was like the most cathartic experience. It's like, I'm really on my own now. You know, mom can't tell me this is an absolute waste of my money.
Yeah. The first one was the Wii U remaster version?
Yeah. I never got it on the GameCube because... that's part of it. Okay. Good. I might die. We'll see. Let's see. My mother didn't want me to pick up Wind Waker because... We already had Ocarina of Time, so why do you need Wind Waker?
Was it you've already beaten that, or was it like...
No, you just don't own any Zelda game, therefore you own all Zelda games. Oh, yeah. Games.
You got all the Zelda games.
It was,
exactly.
That was the hardest thing to get past.
Yeah, for me, like, my dad played games, so it was, like, less tough of a sell, but it was very much like a... It was kind of like a quest to... You have to beat the game as quickly as possible so that we can sell it.
Ah.
And get you another one.
Yeah, my parents...
Oh my god, wow. I can't see anything! I literally just can't see anything, oh my god. What just happened? Oh boy.
Mess happened.
Absolutely.
You okay? Yeah, you're fine.
I guess these turrets, these overhealing things are just... Oh my god. Ooh, another red item.
Yeah.
What do you think? Can I get another shield to go
yeah,
even
you
further
can.
Beyond?
Can
I go 3x my health?
Let's see. Let me look. Hopefully I'm safe just standing here. The shields... No, it just increases how much.
Hmm.
Yeah.
What should I get then? Should I get another clover?
Yeah, it's not a terrible idea. That'll mean more missiles.
More missiles. More missiles, less problems.
Let's see. I guess bazooka is not a terrible one. That gives you a AoE to your hits. I just don't know how useful that is.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. It's... I don't know what anything is anymore. I'm just going to get a bunch of hooves so I can dodge that one attack on the boss. That's literally all I have in mind right now.
That's what I've been doing.
I'm like, I want enough speed so I can dodge that one attack. The end.
I wonder how effective he is at hitting you, like, outside the area, like if you're flying.
Yeah, that's a good question. Wait, did we beat the boss? Oh, no, that was just the temporary boss. Oh,
that was the bonus boss. I don't think we've actually bothered to find the portal yet.
Uh-oh. I put down my Healy thing back there then.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
Do you really think we're going to have trouble?
Nah, I mean, I definitely very much almost died with the healing thing, so
true.
Maybe. Okay, yep. I love having this many hooves. 13 hooves, good time.
Gotta go fast.
Running around in the pink.
I'm curious how unplayable this game would be at, like, 100 hooves.
I would imagine, like, extraordinarily so.
Ow. I can't just... tank those. Where the hell is the teleporter? Oh, it's got to be underground. Okay, not there. Here it is.
Okay, I'm starting to lose control of my character. At 13.
It's even worse with me, because I've got my dodge, which is based on my movement speed. So I dodge, and I'm nowhere where I started. I'm dead.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Oh my god, the lag is insane.
Good luck in there.
The lag is ridiculous. I can see nothing. And everything. I'm going in. Oh my god.
It's okay. You just by existing have deleted most of them.
It's true. They're almost gone. Oh, man. I'm not the one to die first.
By the way, if you want to do something silly, just start stacking a ton of fuel cells.
Okay.
And your next red item, get that face thing.
I love silly.
Because I notice you are effectively just a walking missile platform, but getting a lot of those reduces the cooldown. Yeah, your cooldown is now 3 seconds on the missile launcher, 4 seconds.
Oh boy.
And every single one of those will reduce it further.
Gotta remember to actually, like, grab these little candy pieces that are rolling down the hill. Kinda Pac-Man. This is the craziest it. Game of Pac-Man.
It's working.
Oh god, I'm gonna throw up.
Look at all these bodies.
Oh my god.
All right, what is your cooldown? Is it down to 3 seconds? It is. Keep stacking those fuel cells.
Oh, oh no! Oh my god. What the hell?
Well.
Well. That's that was that.